elenzile uthi cha thina we didn't know that Ramaphosa was going to increase his cabinet numbers, right? So my question, my immediate question from that, I was like, wait, if you knew, what were you going to do? I mean, that remains a fact. If you knew that Ramaphosa was going to increase his cabinet as DA, what were you going to do? Because you are the beneficiaries in this thing. What were you going to do? So it's not like really there's something that they were going to do, some magic that they were going to perform by that. It's not like there's something very key, very interesting that they were going to do. Really, there's nothing that they were going to do, right? Isn't it? Mina, guys, I honestly believe that there's really nothing that they were going to do. It's just them telling us, hoi, Tina Jana, we are afraid that but what are we going to do? Malema, on the other hand, has got something to say about this government of national confusion that, a lot of people actually are slamming this thing, right? And I haven't, very few people are agreeing with what we are seeing here. You will remember that, Pela, we were told that a lot of people like the DA and the ANC government. That's what people are, that's what other journalists will write and will tell you, that this thing, a lot of people like this thing, but to be quite honest, very few people like this whole idea. But yeah. Let me read this article that was written by IOL. The heading of the article says, Helen Zille, DA, had absolutely no idea Ramaphosa was increasing cabinet so substantially. Written by Uloisan Marumo, senior digital journalist at IOL, says, the heading says, Chair of the Democratic Alliance DA Federal Council, Helen Zille, said it had no idea, it had no information on the massive increase in the national executive post and cabinet until President Ramaphosa made the announcement in the televised address on Sunday night. Mina, I'm still going to ask the question, if they knew, what were they going to do? That remains an unanswered question, right? That consists of members of the DA, IFP, PA, PAC, FF Plus, and Good Part, all political parties who have signed on the part, who have signed to be part of the government of national unity, which is the government of national confusion, like I said. But, I don't want you to be confused. This is what I want you to do. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. So, okay, let's go on. In this article written by IOL, they say in an interview with the broadcaster Newsroom Africa on Monday morning, Zille said the DA had no knowledge that Ramaphosa's cabinet configuration until the president made the announcement on a televised address. It says, I suppose everybody had to compromise a bit, but we didn't know that the president was going to increase the cabinet so substantially and give the ANC so much than what was proportionally their due. We did not know about the size of the cabinet What we did know was about portfolios we were getting and which deputy ministers we were getting. That we did know. But for the rest, we did not have any information. Fair enough. We did not have any info. Let's take your word for it. Had you had a info prior to the announcement of that, what is it that you would have done? It's a question that everybody should be asking, because we did, at this moment, it doesn't help us. But let's proceed. Zilla, however, added that the DA also knew that the cabinet portfolios like agriculture and land reform will be split. She said the information one could not conclude that cabinet was going to increase because some departments could be contracted in a bid to manage the size of the cabinet. The DA has been pushing for a leaner cabinet in the run-up to the May 2029 general elections, right? Then if you look, Helen Zilliger said, we are accepting our 6 positions. Certainly, the expansion of the cabinet has nothing to do with the DA taking more positions than it's entitled to in terms of the proportionality clause. The expansion comes from many other parties getting a lot more than they entitled to. I don't know if you have noticed, if you are noticing from this, that the DA, in fact, DA here, they are playing a role of supervising others who's getting what. And have you noticed that it's always DA that is complaining, speaking about proportionality, about equal share? DA is concerned about power. Yes, DA is so obsessed about, you know what, we shouldn't get, like, they are obsessed. But let's proceed. Indeed, there is an increase in cabinet, and we had no idea of the extent to which that could occur. We now got 6 ministries, which less than proportional due. So the DA is not contributing to the increased size of the cabinet. That is not sure. We will continue with our 6 portfolios. We do look to do our very best and to add much value we can to show the DA difference in the work that we do. Obviously, we will want much smaller cabinet, but in the context, we will do our very best. If the proportionality clause had been properly applied, we will have got 6 and the ANC will have got 12, and few parties will have gotten some more so than could have been 18 cabinet ministers in all. What are you doing about it? Nothing. So, kusizani ukhuluma ngayo ke? Hoy, 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 hoy. It really doesn't help. IOL, quoting Julius Malema on the other hand, he said, the EFF have noted the announcement by Cyril Ramaphosa, what is essentially the ANC and the DA cabinet, confirming our standing view that the government of national unity was nothing but a smokescreen for the ANC to secure a predetermined grand coalition with the racist DA. Do you, at this moment, looking at the way things are happening, do you even disagree with ETA, or like the views held by EFF? Personally, I wouldn't. I don't. In fact, I don't disagree with them. I fully concur with the views shared by EFF here. They wanted that. It's a grand coalition. There's nothing up beyond that. Like, really, guys? It's a coalition. Do you see a coalition here? Or you see, government of national unity. Do you see a government of national unity? Or you just see a coalition? Look at our DA, the way they speak.